This is a quick blink of the eye video to talk about the different types of algorithm analysis using asymptotic notation, and also how we can talk about problem runtimes instead of just algorithm runtimes. You should have seen the asymptotic definitions video first, but this one kind of stands on its own from the other videos in the series. So we generally talk about best case, average, and worst case analysis. Now, best case is oftentimes too optimistic to be helpful. For instance, for search in an unordered list, best case is constant time. The first element you look at is what you need, done. On the other hand, you might consider the cases when search fails. Even in the best case, if it's a working algorithm, that's going to take linear time. The best case of a program like merge sort or heap sort might be interesting, but knowing that insertion sort has linear best case time just isn't that important. Average case analysis is good if you either know what distribution your data will be, which might be hard, or you have a randomized algorithm and you take the average over your own random choices. Especially for randomized algorithms, that's really useful, but sometimes the math can get hairy. Worst case analysis is probably the most common. It's pessimistic, but if you can prove good bounds, it makes a strong statement. Sometimes it's also a lot easier than average case analysis, and for lots of algorithms, it might be the same order growth. Again, considering merge sort over n different values, it has best, worst, and average case runtime of order n log n. The worst case analysis is good enough to really tell us most of the story there. While in quicksort, it tells us a lot less because quicksort's worst case performance is worse than the overwhelming majority of its runs. So we see that which type of analysis we might use depends on which algorithm we are discussing. Besides talking about algorithm performance, we can also talk about problem complexity. So let's consider the problem of sorting, specifically using some comparison-based sorting algorithms. Different algorithms with different runtimes can solve that problem, some being faster, others slower. But we can show that any comparison-based sorting algorithm must use at least order n log n comparisons. This goes beyond saying that algorithms we have already discovered need that many comparisons. It even holds for algorithms nobody has thought up yet. Any comparison-based sort will need, worst case, order n log n comparisons. Now, merge sort, which is a comparison-based sort, can sort using order n log n comparisons. That means that comparison-based sorting is a theta, n log n problem. It requires that many comparisons from any algorithm, and the bound can be achieved. It doesn't matter that worse algorithms like bubble sort are out there. We can now say the problem of comparison-based sorting is an n log n problem. So within the asymptotic notation videos, this one can come pretty much anywhere after the first one. There are a bunch of other videos in that series, but that's it for this one, quick and dirty. But now I think I actually need to blink. Like I said, a blink of the eye video. I'm ready for my staring contest.